So in our last video, we welded together an encasement for the bottom of the anvil at the base and poured lead in there and welded everything shut. Since then, I went ahead and ran some more beads around and filled up any small holes here and there. Also, in an attempt to pre-warm it up, because I'm going to hopefully be able to heat this whole thing up and melt some lead inside and maybe pour some more in, but maybe that's just wishful thinking. Anyway, but before we do that, I've got a lot of welds to grind down, so let's jump over, throw this in the bed of my truck, or on the tailgate. We're going to grind everything flat, get in frame, and we're going to grind everything flat with the grinding disc, and then with the flap disc to make it all very uniform in texture, except for the two sides where the letters are. I like those. Let's jump over and grind away. I think that's all the metalworking I have in me today. I think it took about an hour to grind this down, maybe an hour and a half, to grind everything, all the welds off, and everything up to 80 grit on the flap disc. It's pretty warm right now, but I think I need to get my forge up and running for me to be able to melt the lead inside, because the steel is gonna soak away or steal all of the heat away if I try and use a propane tank or a torch. And I think I just need to use the forge over here. I still have a couple things left to weld onto it and then grind it down, and then that'll be done. After that's done, we will melt the lead inside, add some more, because I'm pretty sure there's a small cavern. It's a bit cavernous inside the base, because you can kind of hear it. Right there. So what I need to do is I need to melt this down. It'll free up some space. I don't know how much, hopefully enough so I can pour the rest of my lead in. And then weld this back. Or weld this plug, grind that down, probably grind the face flat, and then we'll heat treat it, and then it's done, and then we'll mount it. That's like 5 more videos. Oh well, I'm enjoying this one. This came out really cool, and it's really heavy. If I'm able to pour more lead in here, I can get it up to 100 pounds. But it's pretty heavy right now. I'm pretty happy with it too. I don't think it'd look very good. Well, maybe it would look, nah. If I put lead in here, it'd affect the rebound 100%. And the rebound's pretty good right now. maybe somewhere around the 60% range, which I'm okay with. It's not a real anvil. You know, it's got lead in there, a sponge of a metal that'll soak up energy. Anyway, so yeah, next episode, we're going to be next video, we're going to be doing final assembly on the forge and all the grinding. Actually, I already have some of the footage. And then we will be, the next video, we're going to be melting this down in there, then pouring more lead in, then welding it shut. And then the next one will be heat treating this, of course, in the forge. Just need to get this upper section hot. And then we're going to be mounting it on a stump. And that's it. That's going to be the anvil. It's going to be start to finish. It's been 3, 4, it'll be 10 videos in total. But we're pretty close to being done. And other than that, I'll be finishing the iron caster by doing a little demo of it, a little conclusion to the series. And then, let's see, what else do I have going on? Couple things left for that. I have to do the fretboard and the headstock, and then that'll be done. And then finishing, it'll be done. And yeah. That grinding tired me out. If you like this video, go and throw a like, subscribe if you want to see more, comment on what you think of this process. If you like it, if you don't like it, if it's something you'd try, if it's something you'd never try. Either way, I appreciate you guys stopping by, and yeah. See you in the next video. Bing!